Today we're going to look at how to do a particular problem in the post lab for the moles, mass, and volume experiment. It's the problem with the volume of atoms in angst and their radii are given in angstroms, and their volume needs to be calculated in cubic angstroms. The problem is not as hard as it looks. I'll give two examples here. Neither of these atoms are actually in the problem, so these will be good examples, barium and sulfur. They're giving the angstrom, which is symbolized by the A with a ring on the top, as 1 times 10 to the minus 10th meters. They also give the formula for the volume of something, 4/3 pi r cubed. We simply use this formula here, put in the radius, in this case for sulfur, cube it, multiply by pi, and then multiply by 4/3. This is rounded to 3 significant figures because the radius is given with 3 significant figures. Now, some of the radii have 2 significant figures if they're less than 1 angstrom, so be sure you round it to 2 in that case. Now, just to be safe, I'm going to actually store that volume on my calculator, the actual volume on my calculator, but I'll write it down as 4.85. Then I'll do the same thing for the other atom that's asked, barium. You notice that the radius of barium is about twice as much as sulfur, but the volume is much, much greater, and that's because the radius is cubed. Now we're going to find the ratio, how many sulfur atoms are needed to occupy the volume of a barium atom, or in general, how many of the smaller atoms are needed to occupy the volume of the larger atom. Just take the larger one, the larger volume, and divide by the smaller volume, and you'll get a unitless number. I rounded this one to 3 significant figures. You might have a volume that has only 2 significant figures, in which case you round it to 2.